ASL Services has worked with Orange County government in the past for many different aspects. And so when we were asked to come here and provide interpretations for the deaf community, we of course were right on par and we were happy to do it.
There's two interpreters at each briefing because research shows that your brain tires after 20 minutes. So of course we're processing information. ASL and English are completely two different languages, which is why I'm not signing for myself right now. I have Jonathan. For the brain to process information, it takes a lot on your brain. Usually when people ask, you know, after work, oh, aren't you tired? It's my brain that's tired. So with something as serious as a press conference, especially with everything that's going on right now, we want to have two people to make sure that we are conveying the message accurately.
To prep for the press conferences, the first thing we do is we make sure we watch all prior press conferences, right? We have to make sure that we're completely up to date on the news and that we know exactly what's going on out in the community. As a team, we sit down and we look at the whole speech and we look at any nuances in language that we might convey, and we want to make sure we convey them consistently throughout the board. So for example, Jill and I will sit down, we'll review different signs, we'll review different aspects and different concepts of how to communicate that, and then we'll get up and do it. It's incredibly important to have interpreters at press conferences and events in general, and we want to provide equal access to our community. We want to make sure that we are providing equity all across the board, and we are promoting equality. I speak Spanish, so if there's any Spanish questions that come from Spanish media or anything that comes out and is being communicated to the Latino community in Spanish, then I am able to step in and provide that directly into American Sign Language.
ASL interpreters need to be animated because there is so much grammar involved just in the face. You have nouns, verbs, adjectives, everything. You have WH questions, you have yes, no questions. All of it is on your face. So you have to make sure that you're not just being deadpan because you're not getting anything across. And of course the intent is shown on your face as well. So that's why we are so animated. When I went to college, I didn't know what I wanted to be. And then it wasn't until I found interpreting and I actually started doing it that I saw that there are so many different aspects of it, and I get to experience multiple careers in a way. You know, I get to go to a doctor's office one day and then I get to go to a college the next day. I get to go to a local theme park another day, or a job training. I get to experience so many different professions, even a press conference, you know, that other people don't. They only get their own profession, where I get a taste of everything.
It feels great to have positive support and positive feedback from our community, and knowing that we get up here and we do the best that we can, and that the deaf community loves it and enjoys and appreciates that the mayor's office is putting us there in front and able to provide interpretations for everyone. Actually, when I first started interpreting, from my alma mater, I went to Gallaudet University. It's the only deaf university in the world. And so I studied there in Washington, D.C., which is very far from Florida. And one of my classmates and one of my old teachers reached out and she said, "It's so great to see you up on TV. It's great to see an interpreter of color being put in the front line." So I'm excited about that, and I love that. It's an aspect.